Monday. Mondays are Guns for Girls days. And the first thing I'm going to say about arm workouts and working out with weights is that a lot of women have this, the incorrect belief that if they work out with weights, that they're going to get bulky and look like a man. And I'm here to tell you, not going to happen. If that was going to happen, you would either have a whole lot of testosterone in your body naturally, or you'd be lifting really heavy weights, and I mean really heavy weights. What I have here is not going to do that. What I have here is going to give you definition where you want it. It's going to get rid of the flabbiness. When you wave goodbye to somebody and you see it waving, or you just don't like the fact that you have no definition in your arms where you used to have some. And just general like mushiness that you're just not happy with. So you're not gonna look like a man. It's very, very difficult to get to that stage. So don't worry about that, just have fun. Let's start our warm up. If you've never done this workout before, I would encourage you to do it without weights the first time, or very, very light weights. You're going to be worked out from your forearm all the way up to your shoulder. Okay, let's do arm circles. And then, you know, another thing that's very important is if you have not worked out in a long time or ever, you should check with your doctor. Sorry, I need to plug in my mic. You need to check with your doctor before you start. Just to get the okay, same if you have had any injuries. If you've had any injuries, it's important that you get that checked out and get the all clear so you know that you're good. Okay, grab that wrist. Give yourself a good stretch. Now lace your fingers and push towards me. And then lift up. I'm so glad you guys are here. I was very tired this morning. Did not sleep well at all. But when the alarm goes off, I know I'm going to feel better if I just get up. Okay, this is a new version of Guns for Girls. I like to mix them up because I don't like to do the same thing all the time, so I just assume that other people don't either. So you'll see some familiar moves, some new moves. Okay, diamond push-ups. Diamond push-ups are when you put your hands in the shape of a diamond. You can touch them. You can keep them a couple inches apart. That's cool. But when you press down, your hands, this is where your hands should be, right in your chest, okay? You've got to keep really good form. Your body is tight. Then we're going to do a dumbbell curl with a tricep extension. So you're going to be palms up, standing up, okay? You're going to curl the dumbbell. Then you're going to bend over, and you're going to extend the dumbbell, squeezing those triceps like crazy, okay? And all of that motion is one rep. Then we're gonna do scarecrows. You're gonna hold two dumbbells. You're gonna have your arms out to your sides. You're going to extend your forearms out until your arms are straight. And what are you squeezing? Mainly your triceps, all into the back of your shoulder. So there you go. We're gonna do 15 diamond push-ups. Again, if you're doing them on your knees, totally fine. You wanna be on this part of your knee, not this part of your knee. That is not, and I'm not going to time us. I was looking down at my phone for my timer, but we don't need that. Okay, are your hands in the shape of a diamond? Is your body totally tight? Even if you're on your knees, you're tight from your head to your tip to your knees. For me, I'm up. My whole body's tight. My hands are about 3 inches apart. We're going to do 15. Squeeze those triceps on the way up. Five more. Good job. Okay, moving that out of the way. Okay, dumbbell curl with tricep extension. I'm going to go with my eights. You're going to put your feet hip width apart. Your core is tight, your shoulders back. Your palms are facing out. Okay, you're gonna do a full dumbbell, squeezing those biceps. Rotate the weights, bend over, extend, squeezing those triceps. And doing 15 of those. Do not release your core. You're squeezing biceps, then squeezing triceps. How are you feeling? We have five more. Squeeze, squeeze. Three, two, one. There you go. Next, we're going to scarecrow. Very light weights. Or no weights at all. I'm going with my fives. Your arms are up. Elbows in a 90 degree angle. Squeeze. And you are gonna feel those triceps start to scream pretty early on. Your core is tight, little bend in your knees. The moment you cannot control the weight, I have five more and I'm dying, but I still feel like I have control of the weight, so I'm moving forward. If at any time you don't, or you cannot keep your arms up, drop those weights completely. Give yourself a hug. Drop the weights completely, or drop to a lower weight. But finish the reps. Okay, we're gonna finish out our diamond push-ups. Are you happy? And we're doing 12 this time. So you're even luckier. Whew. Okay, you ready? Hands in the shape of a diamond. They should be right under your chest. When you go down, your whole body should be tight, your feet together. I want 12. Four more. I have found that some days, some Mondays, a lot of Mondays, can be my toughest day. And that's because, stretch your triceps. I'm usually busy on Sundays, running around, doing stuff, and I'm not so good about drinking water as I am the other days. So, I can tend to be a little bit more dehydrated. Okay, we are doing great. Let's go on to our next set of exercises. Okay, the first one is shoulder press with a rotation. You're gonna sit on your ball, holding your dumbbells, your palms facing you. You're gonna rotate your hands up to the top and back down. Then we're gonna do tricky tricep dips, which you will need a chair or a bench for. I don't have good chairs for exercising, so I have my little bench, and a tricky tricep dip is you can have your knees at a 90 degree angle or out in front of you for more of a challenge. You're gonna go down, you're gonna come up like 2 inches, back down and up to the top. Those are hard. Do not expect that you're gonna be able to go all the way down. If at a certain point you cannot do anymore, just hold, or just go down and stay in a hold like this. There are ways you can modify that very easily. So then we're gonna do a hammer twist. So we're gonna do a hammer curl up and down, then you're gonna twist it so your palms are facing the back of the room, and then you're gonna curl up. So you're gonna work those biceps, and then you're gonna work those forearms by curling up. So a lot harder than it sounds. going to go with my 10-pound weights for shoulder presses. You cannot go as heavy in shoulder presses as you can in like chest presses. Okay, your palms are facing you. Rotate up, keep that core tight on the ball. This is a slow and controlled movement. The weights are not flinging. I have five more, and these are getting really heavy. There you go. Put the ball away so you don't trip on it. Tricky tricep dips. They are tricky. They are hard. Most important thing, again, your feet can be out. Your legs can be out totally straight for more of a challenge, or bent for a little bit less of a challenge. If you cannot do the up and down, if it is just too much for you to be doing this, stay in this position, squeeze those triceps, and hold until we're done with the reps, okay? Remember, your back slides down in front of the chair. Good form, core tight, shoulders back. You're going to go down, come up a couple inches, go down, and then all the way up. That's why it's tricky. These are so hard. I'm gonna take a little break. I have five more left to do. So I'm gonna keep my knees bent for the remaining five. More. Whew. Sit up and stretch. I told you those were hard. There is no getting around it as far as those are concerned. I'm sorry, I'm yawning. What I do. Okay, hammer twist. I'm going to go with hold on a second. I am confused because I feel like I forgot to do something. Yeah, I did. We did the second set of diamond push-ups. Sorry, I forgot to do those second sets. I'm a little out of it this morning. Okay, dumbbell curl with tricep extension. Okay, feet hip width apart, core tight. Curl them up. Rotate them, bend over, extend. We're doing 12. Curl, squeeze those biceps, now squeeze those triceps. Sorry I messed that up. It happens sometimes, especially when I'm tired. Okay, now we're gonna do scarecrow, and I'm sticking with my fives. These feel really good to me. Your arms are up, elbows at a 90 degree angle. Squeeze those triceps. Your core is tight. I know these are hard. I have three more. Drop the weights if you can't keep them under control. Okay, so now we're gonna go back into our other set. Again, I'm really sorry. Okay. I do not know what I did just there. I mean, I know what I did. I don't know how I did it. Whew, okay. So now we're gonna do the hammer curl. And I'm gonna go with eights. If it was just a straight hammer curl, I might go with tens, but not with that other movement, okay? You have a regular hammer curl. The ends of the dumbbells are facing me. Your feet have a little, and your knees have a little bend in them, your core's tight. Regular hammer curl, up and down, squeezing that bicep. Turn your palms towards the back of the room. Squeeze those forearms. That was two. Do not release your core. That is gonna help you have good form, stay stable. These are harder than they look. I think this is eight for me. Squeeze those biceps, squeeze those forearms. That's 10. I have five more. Three more. And oh my gosh, I still feel in control of the weights. I am fatigued, my muscles are burning, but I want to finish with the eights. Shake that out. Oh my goodness. Have a little bit of water. We have one more set of those. What did I go with last time? Shoulder press with rotation. I think I did 10. I'm gonna go with 12s this time. See how it goes. You are on the ball. You have got to keep your core tight to keep you stable. Your weights are under your chin, palms facing you. Rotate and push up, and I want 12 of those. This is a slow and controlled movement. Two more. I'm dying right now, but I'm going to finish with the 12s because I feel like I can. You will know when you need to drop down versus when you can power through with the weights you have, just taking a little bit of break. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. All right. Now we're going to do our tricky tricep dip. So you're going to go down, you're going to come up 2 or 3 inches, go all the way back down and all the way back up. That's why it's called tricky, and that's why it sucks. However, it's effective. So there are going to be many exercises that you have a love-hate relationship with, okay? Everything is engaged. My back is sliding down the front. Oh, I forgot to do the tricky part. So I have 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 5. So I'm going to bend my knees and finish out. It's still hard. Whew. Put your hands on your hips, your thumbs facing forward, and push forward, and that really helps stretch out in your shoulders, down into your triceps. Okay, now we have a hammer twist to do. Okay, so I'm going to stick with my eights. Because remember, we have that forearm portion of this that's tricky. Okay, so feet hip width apart, core tight. We're doing 12 of these. Hammer up, rotate them. Sorry. Hammer up, down, and then do a curl. Keep that core tight, shoulders back. You have a little bend in your knee. You're going to notice that some mornings I'm dropping down as I started to feel myself lose control of the weights, and I don't want that. You are going to notice some mornings you are just don't feel as strong, you don't feel as on point. And I'm just going to tell you this, you're a human being and things happen, and you know, you're not going to have a great workout every single day. That is not the way it works. Okay. So, we have another 7 minutes. So I'm going to work through a series of exercises, and we're going to get as far as we can get. Okay, so the next one is a wrist flexion. I'm just going to go exercise by exercise, demonstrate it, and then we'll do it. You want very light weights. Your palms are up. All you're going to do is squeeze. Okay, you're flexing that wrist 15 times, okay? Nothing else is moving. Your feet are hip width apart. Your core is tight. 15. Squeeze. Okay, keep these weights. This is what I'm going to do for my shoulder sweeps this morning. Shoulder sweeps. Feet hip width apart, core tight. You put one arm out to your side, shoulder height. You sweep it across. So you're basically your bicep ends up on the side of your boob. And you hold it there. Then you sweep. That's one. One and one is one. We're doing 10. Squeeze. You want to squeeze those muscles, your entire arm, when you sweep across. You're definitely going to have to drop your weight or drop to a lower weight if you started too heavy. Oh my gosh. Those are a beast. I usually start with eights on those and go to fives. I just couldn't do it. Okay, now we're going to do a wrist burn. So you're going to hold your arms straight out in front of you. Rotate your wrists up and down now. Again, you want light weights. I'm going with my fives. I'm going to see how it goes. Arms out in front. Do 15. 12. 13. 14. 15. Oh my gosh. Such a small move, but holy crap. Okay. Next we're going to do punching bag. I'm going to get 8 pound weights. Your feet are hip width apart, and you're gonna, one and one is one. I want your entire core tight. I want that rotation in your trunk. But again, you're keeping everything tight. There's a little dip between each one. You're coming up on your toe, and one and one is one. You can also do uppercuts if you want. Does not matter to me which one you do. You can split it up halfway, but we're doing 15. Remember, one and one is one. Your core is tight. doing uppercuts for the last five. Oh my gosh. Okay. Let's do those wrist flexions again for 12. Arms down by your side, palms facing out, little bend in your knees, 12. Squeeze those forearms. Okay. Next, we're gonna do the shoulder sweeps again for a count of 8. Okay, your one arm's to the side, sweep it, squeeze that entire arm and up, okay? I'll show you from the side. Okay, that's what we're working with. If you have to drop the weight, do it, but finish the reps. Two more. Oh my gosh. Oh, those are so hard. Okay. We're gonna do the wrist burn one more time, and then we are done. Okay, 15. Sorry, 12. We're done. Take your fingertips, put your other fingertips across them like this, and press down. You should feel an amazing stretch. You're pushing your fingertips towards your body, okay? And you should feel an amazing stretch through your forearm, which got a nice little workout up into your biceps. Grab your wrist. Okay, and then if you have a bench, a ball, a chair, get down, have your hands on top, and just let your chest sink towards the floor. And you'll feel this in your arms, your chest, your shoulders. Then put your elbow up, and you want to stretch your tricep, okay? So you're kind of letting your body come towards the ground while your elbow is up on the bench, chair, ball, and you'll feel that great, great stretch. Then come out to the side. Stretch that bicep. Again, your hand is on top. Adjust it as needed until you know that it's the right stretch for you and you're feeling it in the right place. And we are going into our abs. So I hope you'll stick around for that 10 minutes. That's why I'm moving right into it. We all got stuff to do. Okay, the first exercise is going to be an ab hold. Let me just adjust this a little bit so you can see me better. Okay, so the first one is an ab hold. So you're gonna get an 8 to 10 pound dumbbell or a 5 pound, whatever, it doesn't matter. You're gonna sit on your mat, you're gonna lean back, then you're gonna lift your legs into a flat position and put your weight, okay? And we are gonna do this for 30 seconds. Okay. Stopwatch for 30 seconds. So, get your weight. Lean back on like your sit bones. Get those feet up. Squeeze those abs. get wobbly if you release your abs. Keep them squeezed, squeeze, squeeze. You notice I make you do this with the dumbbell after we've just done Guns for Girls. And it was intentional, sorry. Good job. Okay. Next, we're gonna go in an oblique crunch. Okay, you lay on your side. Your bottom arm is in front of you. Your hand is lightly behind your head. Your knees are stacked. And you're gonna squeeze, and you wanna squeeze your obliques. Keep your hand there if you need to make sure you're doing it right. We're doing 30 seconds on this side. Squeeze. We're more than halfway there. Almost done. Good job. Other side. Same rules apply. Okay. Bottom arm is down in front of you. Left arm is resting. Fingers are resting lightly behind your head. Crunch up. Touch it to make sure you know you're squeezing the right muscle. Less than 10 seconds, come on. There you go. Now, get a little bit of water. Okay, now we're gonna do a straight leg raise for 30 seconds. Your hands are under your butt. You're gonna squeeze your abs to get your legs up and lower them down. That is a controlled movement. That's when your abs are really working. Okay, I'm gonna stand that right there and then I can see it better. Okay, squeeze your abs for the ups and the downs. Squeeze, and don't forget to breathe. So you want to move at a pretty good pace. Come on, we're almost done. 3, 2, 1. Good for you. Good, good, good. Okay. So next, we have a side-to-side Supergirl. Okay, side to side Supergirl. You want as much room as possible because you're going to be moving around a little bit during this one. Okay, so the whole goal is you have your mat. You're going to be in a plank. You're going to go side to side. Once you get here, you're going to crunch your knee to your elbow. Now, you're going to feel this all in here. These are the muscles you're going to be squeezing. Okay? Back and forth, back and forth. We're going to do this one for 30 seconds. Okay? You're going to be great. So you're in a plank. 1, 2. The motion of your hands and feet should match. So when you go side to side, they want to move at the same time. Side, side, squeeze, squeeze. And I know these are challenging. They're challenging for me too. If you're not there yet and you can't do these, do them in place or just stay in a plank. One more, finish this up. That's good. You guys did a good job with those. Okay. next one. Is up and out, okay? Hands under your butt. Legs are all straight. You're gonna go up, your abs are gonna pull your legs up, they're gonna lower them down, and then you're gonna go out. So you're gonna squeeze your abs to get your legs up, to get your legs down, to control your legs, keep them off the ground. You are also going to have to squeeze all through here to work those legs, keep them from hitting the ground, and having them make a great motion. Okay? You want a great range of motion when you go out. Okay? You're going to be mad at me, but try not to be. 45 seconds. Okay? Squeeze those abs the whole time. This is such a controlled movement. There are no flingy legs. There are no sharp, fast movements. Don't forget to breathe, and don't forget to squeeze. Come on, you're doing great. We have 5 seconds left. And we're done with those. Okay, the next one we're gonna do, I love it. Not gonna lie, get some water. And get, I'm gonna go with a 15-pound weight. Get a heavy weight, but heavy for your fitness level. Okay? Stack your knees. You are going to have this dumbbell resting on the outside of your knee, and you are going to open up, but you're going to keep your feet attached. Ooh, I just got the nicest hip hop. Okay, 30 seconds on each side. Squeeze. Keep that core tight. I know it's hard. Keep going. 5 more seconds. Good job. Other side. Okay, are you ready? Feet stay connected, open up. You've got to squeeze. I know, this is our last one though. And then we're done, and it is 6:11, so we're 1 minute past our goal. All right, that is it. Lay on the ground. Give yourself a nice, nice stretch. Put your leg over, keeping your shoulders on the floor. Done, people. Thank you for joining me. I really appreciate it. I'm always available to answer questions, talk to you about your concerns, advice I have for staying motivated, all of those things. I'm always here if you need absolutely anything. Okay, so tomorrow will be Torchlight Tuesdays, and it's the best day of the week, hardest day of the week, but the best day of the week. And another area where if you work it, those muscles will come, without a doubt. And not so much muscles bulking out. That's not what we're talking about. We're talking about definition and strength. And you get stronger and you will feel it in everyday life. Climbing stairs, running after your kids, doing a lot of walking, you know, bringing the groceries into the house, whatever it is, okay? So have an awesome Monday. I hope you have a great week. And I will post tonight with the time tomorrow. Bye.